Thank you for listening to episode 17 of the Catholic Servant Podcast, and I'm your host, Alexandra Kubebatu, and this is where we feature faithful individuals of business, ministries, and apostolates who strive to give glory to God in all things while sharing valuable business or work-related tips and inspiring messages. And today I have an open letter to parents of children with special needs, and I want to encourage you and let you know that you're not alone in this journey. Many of you who know me outside of the podcast and on social media and whatnot know that we have a baby, our baby Gigi with Down syndrome. So I want to commiserate some of these feelings, but let's go ahead and start with a prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. My Queen and my Mother, I give myself entirely to you, and to show my devotion to you, I consecrate to you this day my eyes, my ears, my mouth, my heart, my whole being without reserve. Wherefore, good Mother, as I am your own, keep me and guard me as your property and possession. Amen. My dear sister or brother in Christ with a child with special needs, I'm reaching out to let you know you're not alone. There's a great number of us that have been blessed by a beautiful child with special needs. We're all constantly challenged at every level in body, mind, and spirit. And sometimes I think back to when times were simpler and hope and pray things will slow down enough to enjoy our baby. But it seems like she can't get a sniffle or a tummy bug without some kind of complication. Gigi caught the flu last winter and she was hospitalized and developed several complications. She recovered over several months and now waiting for the dates of her next couple of procedures. Right now, we're in a good place and cherish every moment to simply enjoy our little sunshine. But it's difficult with all the doctor appointments, illnesses and therapies. I know you get it. Sometimes it's unrelenting and it's hard to take a breather. And it looks different for each of us, whether it's Down syndrome, autism, Asperger's, ADHD, or any of the others. Mommies and daddies, we were chosen to parent these amazing children. Children that have had to endure more medical issues than we have our entire lifetimes. Children who need a little extra help making sense of this world. It's a world that's difficult to navigate, even for our typically developing children, and for us as adults. And many of us have lots of great support from family and friends, and some of us do not. We are told how strong we are, but the truth is, we could be stretched to a breaking point when we see our child struggling. Sometimes being in a dark hospital room, holding your child for days on end is nothing more than a cold, lonely place, physically, emotionally, and mentally. Having a child with special needs teaches us just how imperfect we really are and how little control we have over anything. And many times we don't have the energy to pray with anything more than tears that stream down our faces and a heart lifted up to the Lord, crying ourselves to sleep. We tend to blame ourselves and feel guilty because we can't make it better, easier, or less painful for our children. But remember, my dear friends, your strength in the Lord will teach us all how to walk with God in heartbreaking moments. Yes, we can glorify God just holding a rosary and signing ourselves as we face some of the toughest moments without words, without long drawn out monologues of eloquent testimony. It's simplicity of heart and yearning for God's love and mercy that gets his attention. Remember always, you are not alone. You are loved. You deserve to take a break. Forgive yourself. You will make mistakes and it's okay. And trust God. My brother and sister, I am with you and praying for you and your family always, sending love and hugs. Let us pray together. Heavenly Father, you know the exhaustion of my body and the pain in my heart. Lord, you know many times I fail and feel overwhelmed with juggling all the responsibilities of raising children with special needs. Help me to find rest in you and to renew my heart with deeper compassion, love, and patience for my children and spouse and all those around me. Send me the grace to find peace in the calling you have for me at this time. Please help me to see that I am enough for my children. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lady of Sorrows, pray for us. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Saint Gianna Beretta Moya, pray for us. Saints Louis and Zelie Martin, pray for us. Saint John Paul II, pray for us. Our guardian angels, watch over us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dearest Catholic servants, please don't hesitate to let me know your special intention so we can pray for you during our next family rosary. My email address is alexandra@thecatholicservant.com, and you can also visit our website at thecatholicservant.com for the transcript of this episode or to share it with someone who may need encouragement. May God bless you.